Hello everyone and welcome back. Today I have for you a general video about the Explorer format. To begin with, what even is Explorer? It is a new non-rotating format on MTG Arena featuring all cards that are legal in Pioneer that also appear on Arena. It is very similar to the tabletop formats. It works the same way. So there is no rebalancing, there is no funny business going on. The cards only work as they are printed. You don't have to be worried about paying attention to some random weekly changes or, you know, cards just doing something else the week after you built your deck. Everything legal in Pioneer that also appears on Magic Arena is legal in this format. So it is my understanding that in the future, they basically want Pioneer and Explorer to basically be the same, so you can practice the format in Magic Arena when you're playing a Pioneer tournament in real life. Cards that only exist digitally are excluded, so there is no, you know, remastered stuff, no anthologies, no jumpstart expansions. None of that stuff is legal in the format. There's a lot of banned cards. Fuel of the Dead, Get This the Hidden Hand, Leyline of Abundance, Lurus is banned, which was, for me, that was a little bit of a surprise. Nexus of Fate, that's probably a good card to ban because, you know, nobody really likes to play against stuff that never lets you take another turn. Wilderness Reclamation, that obviously goes together with that. Veil of Summer, Uro, Titan of Nature's Wrath, Underworld Breach, the Fairy Time Reveler, Once Upon a Time, and Oko. Those are the banned cards in the format. It's been fun exploring the new format, you know, trying to figure out what are the best cards, what are the best decks. And today I want to show you 5 decks to play. So let's start with probably the most popular deck in the format at this moment, and that is Winota. This deck only really plays one way, doesn't really have a plan B, and your plan is to just play a bunch of mana-producing creatures and then drop Winota and get a bunch of free triggers, which means that if you attack with a non-human creature, you get a spin the wheel trigger, which means that you look at the top, is it 6 or 7? Look at the top 6. You look at the top 6 cards and you put a human from those into play attacking and with indestructible. So ideally, what you're trying to do is you go Land World turn 1, you know, then drop like a Prosperous Innkeeper on turn 2, maybe Career's Briefcase to make another token and a treasure. On turn 3, you sack that treasure, drop Winota, immediately attack with those two creatures, and bam, you know, you put a Tovolar's Huntmaster into play with some extra tokens. Perhaps a Kenrith, you know, perhaps Brutal Cathar to deal with your opponent's blockers. And that's basically how the deck works. I think this deck is a lot more... It's better in best of one because you don't really want to sideboard. Like, your deck is a sort of machine that needs all the enablers, all the creatures that produce mana and the treasures and are non-humans to trigger Winota. And then you need the payoff cards. You need the Tovolar Huntmasters. You need Kenrith. There's another version with blue that plays Agent of Treachery. So you can't really sideboard too much. I mean, maybe you can board out some Essica's Chariots if you feel like it's too slow. Maybe on the other hand, you want to keep them if you feel like the matchup is going to be more grindy when they have a lot of removal. But in general, your opponents are going to be bringing a lot better cards for the matchup than you. They're going to be bringing in, you know, Ray of Enfeeblement, like one mana sort of Swords to Plowshares sort of, that like is going to vindicate your creature at instant speed. So their cards are generally going to be a lot better, you know, Sweepers, Anger of the Gods and stuff like that, whereas you don't really improve too much after sideboard. So right now, this deck is all over the best of one format. I would say that I play against this deck in one third, maybe half of my matches when I play best of one just to try out the new deck. And you need to be prepared to beat it. So that is Winota, deck number one. You should be able to find a link to an article with all these decks in the video description. Deck number two, let's do this one. Let's do Explorer Phoenix. I was pleasantly surprised with how good this deck was. I thought that, you know, if you take the historic deck and you lose Dragons, Rage Channeler, and Unholy Heat, which in my opinion are just two of the absolute best cards in the entire historic format. I think Unholy Heat might just be the best card. It is a one mana, basically almost always deal 6 unless it's turn 1 to a creature or planeswalker at instant speed, which is just an unbelievable ratio. And it is very easy to get Delirium, when you have cards like Ledger Shredder, when you have Dragon's Rage Channeler, you know, Fateless Looting, that kind of stuff. Now we move on to Explorer. This deck doesn't have Fateless Looting, it doesn't have DRC, it doesn't have Unholy Heat. So I thought, okay, well, this deck is going to be a lot weaker. But what I found is that it's still, you know, as powerful as you can imagine. It is still as consistent as ever because you still have all the card selection cards. You have Consider, you have Opt, you have Expressive Iteration, most importantly. So you basically just never run out of gas. And thanks to Ledger Shredder, which is the new addition, this card is amazing. You should be playing this in Historic. You should be playing it in Explorer. You should be playing it in Standard. This card is just really, really good. Thanks to all these cards and also Charter Course and Lightning Axe, you are actually really good at putting Phoenix from your hand into your graveyard. So you don't really need Fateless Looting that much. You don't really need Dragon's Rage Channeler that badly because you have 12 other cards. Also, consider sometimes if you're lucky, you can put Phoenix from the top of your deck into your graveyard. But other than that, you have Lightning Axe, you have Charter Course, and you have Ledger Shredder to move Phoenix from your hand into your graveyard and try to bring it back. Speaking of Lightning Axe, I think that card is probably the best removal spell in the format because you need to be able to deal with Winota and you need to be able to deal with Greasefang. These two cards are the centerpieces of both of these combo decks, both Winota and Greasefang. And Lightning Axe is great at killing both and also allowing you to ditch Phoenix from your hand into your graveyard. So I've been very, very happy with that. Don't play less than four. And just in general, this deck is as powerful as the one in Historic. It's consistent. Thanks to drawing so many cards, you are really good at finding your sideboard cards. As you can see, my sideboard is a little bit random right now. I'm just playing a lot of one-offs. I just want to try as many cards as possible. The format's, you know, metagame is still a little bit up in the air, so I'm just trying stuff out. But just in general, make sure you know, have enough cards you can bring in to your deck. When you know, let's say you play against Control, okay, I'm going to have to board out Strangle, I'm going to have to board out, you know, Flame Blast Bolt, I'm going to have to board out these removal spells. I need to make sure I have at least four cards I bring in. So that's where Negate comes in, Narset, Chandra, another Negate. I have at least four. Sometimes you can bring in Brazen Borrower, sometimes you can bring in Mystical Dispute. Also, Ox should come in definitely as well. So just try to make sure you balance those numbers. But other than that, you know, it's still pretty early in the format. So try stuff out as well and try to figure out what works. I thought Fry was a good sideboard card. It also kills Winota. It also kills Greasefang. And it also is good in the mirror because it kills Crackling Drake and Ledger Shredder. So that's my pick for one of the better sideboard cards, maybe underrated at the moment. Explore Phoenix. There's no particular order in which I'm, you know, showing these. So if you want to wait for the power rankings of the format, I think I should be able to do them next week. Number three, and that this is my personal favorite of a deck in the format. It is my pick for the best deck in the format, and for many reasons. First of all, I think Thoughtseize is the best card in the format. It is what it's doing in this deck is it protects your combo. It takes their disruption from their hand. So if they have, you know, their Lightning Axe or if they have their Ray of Enfeeblement, whatever kind of card they may have for Greasefang, Thoughtseize lets you take that away from their hand. Second, Thoughtseize helps you disrupt their combo. They're playing Winota and they open on these hands of, you know, a couple of lands, all these mana creatures, and Winota, you play Thoughtseize, all of a sudden they're left with a bunch of 1/1s. So it helps you against combo. Third, you can even use it on yourself. You can play Thoughtseize to target yourself and discard Perhelion in case you just didn't find another way to put it in the graveyard, and then you can play Greasefang. So it really does it all in this deck. Second reason why I really like this deck is Lightning Axe. As I just explained, it's great against Winota, it's great against other Greasefang decks, and it is really good against Phoenix because it kills Ledger Shredder early on. I'm sure you know how this deck works by now, but you know, just in case somebody doesn't, you're trying to put Perhelion in your graveyard, which is this really expensive vehicle. To do that, you can Thoughtseize yourself sometimes, you have Thrilling Discovery, you have all these vampires making blood tokens that can let you put it in the graveyard, draw a new card, you have Lightning Axe, and you also have Stitcher Supplier to mill yourself. Once you do that, you can play Greasefang, which is a 3-mana creature. It lets you bring back Perhelion with its trigger into play at the beginning of combat. You can immediately crew it because it has the right power of 4 to crew this. Once you crew it, you attack with your 5-5 flying first strike vigilance vehicle that also makes 2/4/4 angel tokens. So you are dealing 13 damage to your opponent, and at the same time, while Parhelion comes back into your hand, it also leaves 4 white angels in play after that. So you get a really strong board position, and usually the game is over. Not in a sense that they're dead immediately, unless you dealt a few damage, you know, in the early game with some of these cheap creatures. But the game is usually over because they can't really recover from taking such a big hit and you having, you know, 12 power in play and then just most likely bringing this back again next turn. So that is the Explorer Greasefang combo, my pick for the best deck in the format right now. This deck is great in best of one and best of three, so doesn't matter which format you prefer. Number four, let's say we take a look at Jeskai Luka. I thought this deck was insanely powerful when it was legal in Standard. This deck is just a combination of cards that ended up being banned a couple of weeks after this deck was dominating Standard. I think it got Agent of Treachery banned, it got Fires of Invention banned. And I wonder if there was one more card. Yorion and cost, at some point it just, you could put it into your hand for 0 mana, but I don't know if they changed the restriction before or after this deck was legal. But anyways, the way this deck works is, you know, you have some control pieces like the classic board sweeps, Anger of the Gods, Doomscar. You're trying to just, you know, slow down your opponent, and at some point you make a token at the end of turn, maybe with Omen of the Sun, maybe with Shark Typhoon by cycling. You know, you can also just play Fable of the Mirror Breaker, get yourself a token that way. There's also cast Lardenvale. There's just a lot of ways to do that. The Wandering Emperor makes a token also at the end of your opponent's turn, conveniently. And when you do that, you can untap, drop Luka, target the token with the -2 ability, and you exile the token, you start revealing cards from your deck until you reveal something with higher value, which is always going to be Agent of Treachery. You put that into play, steal something from your opponent. You have Fires of Invention in the deck, which, you know, lets you do a lot of this stuff like multiple times a turn. So what you can do sometimes, if you have Fires, you can play Luka for free, target your token, get yourself an Agent of Treachery, steal one of their best permanents. Then what you can do is, you still have untapped mana because you didn't really have to pay for your spells. You put Yorion in your hand from your companion zone or sideboard zone, and you drop Yorion again for free. You blink Agent of Treachery, pass the turn, end of turn, this comes back, steals another permanent. All of a sudden you have a huge board and they can't really recover from that usually. So this deck is fun if you don't expect too many, you know, combo decks. So if you're not afraid of getting comboed by Winota or getting comboed by Greasefang, I think this deck could be really, really good. But I'm not sure if it really does have what it takes to fight through those decks. Like, you really need to have an answer for Winota, whether it's Jawari Disruption or Fateful Absence, or hope that you can Anger of the Gods their board away before they can drop Winota. Maybe have Redcap Melee off your sideboard. Basically, what it comes down to is black is really good in this format. Ray of Enfeeblement's great. Thoughtseize is insane, and decks without black, it's going to be hard to, you know, it's going to be hard to disrupt the opponent and have the right sideboard cards at this moment if you're not playing black. But hey, this deck is fun, it's powerful, and I just wanted to pick something else than, you know, all black decks. So Jeskai Luka, and number five, I think my fifth most popular deck was the Arcanist deck. This deck combines like a little bit of everything from red and black. First of all, you have Thoughtseize, again, best card in the format. You have Fatal Push, but I wasn't like entirely happy with how often I was able to trigger Revolt. I have Village Rites to sack my Stitcher Supplier, which is in the deck to help you find Kroxa. And you also have Fabled Passage. Sometimes you make a treasure token from the 2/2 Goblin. So you do have a lot of ways to trigger it, but sometimes they play Winota when you have two lands out, and, you know, it would be better to perhaps just have Ray of Enfeeblement or something instead. But that's just just food for thought. Unfortunately, we don't have Inquisition of Kozilek in the format. We have Duress, which is still pretty decent. It's even good against Winota because they have Fable of the Mirror Breaker. They usually have Issica's Chariot. They usually have the Courier's Briefcase, like Prosperous Innkeeper, not number two, but that can be dressed. So sometimes they are playing main deck Red Cap Melee. So even in that deck, you usually find a lot of targets. And basically the goal of this deck is just play a discard spell turn one, or maybe a Fatal Push on their Llanowar Elf, then drop Arcanist on turn two, and then, you know, attack, get some free value, start milling yourself, that mills more one drops. And eventually you should beat every deck with Kroxa, which is really good against control. There's not that much control right now, so maybe this deck is not, doesn't look, you know, as greatly positioned as it could be. If there was a lot of blue-white control, for example, Kroxa would be insane at just eventually fighting through all their counters and removal spells. But I've been pretty happy with this deck. You can definitely tune it to your liking. Young Pyromancer is not a card you have to play. Instead of Heartless Act, you could play different removal, you know, Power Word Kill, maybe Infernal Grasp. There's a lot of choices. I have actually been a little unhappy with Heartless Act against Phoenix. If Phoenix gets more popular, it would be a little bit awkward against Shredders. Pyromancer, yeah, I'm looking also for a cheap creature that I can copy with the Kiki Reflection. Obviously, when you know the game goes that long, you usually fairly favor yourself. But if there was like one more good creature that I could copy that was cheap, I would be pretty happy with that. So I'm still kind of searching for that. And the 2 mana 3-2 Harvester is not exactly what I was looking for, but yeah, definitely still a lot of room for improvement. But just in general, you know, Arcanist felt pretty powerful to me. Thoughtseize plus Arcanist, great combo. You have decent removal. You have good sideboard. You know, you have Raze for Winota and Greasefang. You have Duress against control, Go Blank for control and graveyard decks. You can bring in War Boss against removal decks, or slow control decks, and you know, Chandra also. There's just a lot of good red and black cards at this moment. So that is it. My picks for top five decks to play in the Explorer format at this moment. If you want to try them out, there should be a link in the description of the video. And as always, thanks to Channel Fireball Marketplace for sponsoring the video. Make sure you check out the website. There's a lot of new Kapina stuff that you can order, and you can find all the deck guides for these decks slowly. I don't think they're all there right now, as we are, you know, most of us are too busy testing for the set championship, but they should be there in, you know, the next couple days, maybe a week. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.